Hello students, how are you all? Today we are going to start our third chapter of Honeysuckle book Tarot's Reward. Tarot's Reward is a popular fairy tale in Japan. It involves the story of a son, Taro, who wanted to fulfill the wishes of his father. Let's read the chapter. I'll read page by page and with that I'll keep explaining you. A young woodcutter named Taro lived with his mother and father on a lonely hillside. All day long he chopped wood in the forest. Though he worked very hard, he earned very little money. This made him sad, for he was a thoughtful son and wanted to give his old parents everything they needed. Now, the difficult words. Lonely means here it is place, a remote place. Chopped means cut into pieces. Earned is to obtain money in return for service. Now, Taro was a young woodcutter. He was a poor boy. He earned money by chopping woods from the jungle. But the money he earned was not sufficient for him and his parents. This made him sad because he was a caring son and wanted to fulfill all their needs. Now, the second paragraph. One evening, when Taro and his parents were sitting in a corner of their hut, a strong wind began to blow. It whistled through the cracks of the hut and everyone felt very cold. Suddenly, Taro's father said, "I wish I had a cup of sake. It would warm me and do my old heart good." This made Taro sadder than ever, for the heartwarming drink called sake was very expensive. "How do I earn more money?" he asked himself. "How do I get a little sake for my poor old father?" He decided to work harder than before. Next morning, Taro jumped out of bed earlier than usual and made his way to the forest. He chopped and cut as the sun climbed, and soon he was so warm that he had to take off his jacket. His mouth was dry and his face was wet with sweat. "My poor old father," he thought. "If only he was as warm as I." And with that, he began to chop even faster, thinking of the extra money he must earn to buy the sake to warm the old man's bones. Now, let's look at the difficult words. Whistled through is passed through with a whistling sound. Cracks is a small gap, the narrow openings. Sake is a popular Japanese drink. Expensive means costly. Made his way to means went to. Now, one day it started blowing cold winds. All people in the home felt cold due to wind passing from the cracks of the wooden house, gaps of the wooden house. His father wished if he could have some sake to energize his heart, to keep his body warm. Taro was sad as he did not have money to buy the expensive sake for his old father. So he decided to work harder than before. Next day, he woke up early and went to the forest to chop woods. He felt tired working by noon. Sun was above his head. It was extremely hot. His mouth was dry. He was sweating. Now, paragraph 5. Then suddenly, Taro stopped chopping. What was that sound he heard? Could it possibly be rushing water? Taro could not remember ever seeing or hearing a rushing stream in that part of the forest. He was thirsty. He He was thirsty. The axe dropped out of his hands and he ran in the direction of wind. Taro saw a beautiful little waterfall hidden behind a rock. Kneeling at a place where the water flowed quietly, he cupped a little in his hands and put it to his lips. Was it water or was it sake? He tasted it again and again, and always it was a delicious sake instead of cold water. Taro quickly filled the pitcher he had with him and hurried home. The old man was delightful with the sake. After only one swallow of the liquid, he stopped shivering and did a little dance in the middle of the floor. Now the difficult words. Kneeling is sitting on knees. Cup means he made a shape of the cup with his hand and fill it with water to taste the water. Delicious is very tasty. Pitcher is an earthen pot. Hurried is rushed. Delighted is happy. And shivering means shaking slightly due to cold. Now, suddenly he heard the sound of falling water. It confused him as there was no river here earlier. Since he was also thirsty, he followed the sound of water. Soon he found a waterfall behind the rock. He went near to the fall and put his hand in the water. To his amaze, he discovered that water was not water but sake. He became happy and filled his pitcher with sake. Upon reaching the house, he gave his sake to his father. The father sipped the sake, and with the one sip only, he stopped shivering and started dancing with joy. Paragraph 8. That afternoon, a neighbor stopped by for a visit. Taro's father politely offered her a cup of sake. The lady drank it greedily and thanked the old man. Then Taro told her the story of the magic waterfall. Thanking them for the delicious drink, she left in a hurry. By nightfall, she had spread the story throughout the whole village. That evening, there was a long procession of visitors to the woodcutter's house. Each man heard the story of the waterfall and took a sip of the sake. In less than an hour, the pitcher was empty. Next morning, Taro started for work even earlier than the morning before. He carried with him the largest pitcher he owned, for he intended first of all to go to the waterfall. When he reached it, he found to his great surprise all his neighbors there. They were carrying pitchers, jars, buckets, anything they could find to hold the magic sake. Then one villager knelt and held his mouth under the waterfall to drink. He drank again and again and then shouted angrily, "Water? Nothing but water." Others also tried, but there was no sake, only cold water. Now look at the difficult words. Greedily is as if desiring more and more. Nightfall is the onset of night. You can also say dusk. Procession of visitors means group of visitors. Intended means planned. Now, a neighbor came in the afternoon. Father offered her a cup of sake. The woman happily took the sake. Father told her about all the incident which happened to Taro. Now this woman spreaded the news to all the people in the village. Every villager rushed to Taro's house and tasted the sake. Next morning, Taro again woke up early, searched the biggest pitcher and went to the waterfall. To his surprise, he found that other villagers were also going to the fall with their jars, pitchers and buckets. Soon, people reached the fall and tasted the sake. But they found that water of the fall was not sake but plain water. Eleventh paragraph. We have been tricked, shouted the villagers. Where is Taro? Let us drown him in this waterfall. But Taro had been wise enough to slip behind a rock. When he saw how things were going, he was nowhere to be found. Muttering their anger and disappointment, the villagers left the place one by one. Taro came out from his hiding place. Was it true? He wondered. Was the sake a dream? Once more he caught a little liquid in his hand and put it to his lips. It was the same fine sake. To the thoughtful son, the magic waterfall gave the delicious sake. To everyone else, it gave only cold water. Now the difficult words was, tricked is deceived, befooled. Drown is to die through submersion in water. Muttering means speaking unclearly. Wondered means felt curious or felt doubt. Now, people became angry and decided to draw Taro in the fall. Taro hid behind the rock and waited till all the villagers went home. He now tasted the water again, but to his surprise, he still felt that it was sake. The fall was giving Taro a sake, while to the villagers it was giving plain water actually. Now the last paragraph of the story. The story of Taro and his magic waterfall reached the Emperor of Japan. He sent for the young woodcutter and rewarded him with 20 pieces of gold for having been so good and kind. Then he named the most beautiful fountain in the city after Taro. This, said the Emperor, was to encourage all children to honor and obey their parents. Sent for means called. He called Taro. The story of Taro and his magic waterfall reached the Emperor of Japan. He called Taro and rewarded him 20 pieces of gold for his goodness and services to his old parents. He named the city's best fountain after Taro. The Emperor did so to encourage other children to take care of their parents. So students, what do we learn from the story? What is the moral of the story? We should take care of our parents and elders. God helps only those persons who takes good care of their parents. Now, this was all about the story, Taro's Reward. I'll see you in the next class with the exercise and question answers of this chapter. Till then, goodbye.